I'm making beaver tails. I'm making beaver tails. I'm making beaver tails. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Some people have called me competitive.
I should be drinking out of my winning cup, too.
A perfectionist.
Yep. That is a good outfit.
I like to get things right.
Yeah.
We're gonna try this again.
I think I'm gonna need this.
The ones that I made in episode 7 didn't turn out. Let's do it again.
Making some beaver tails.
Yes! The ingredients that you need are dry yeast, warm water, sugar, just a pinch, warm milk. I don't have any milk. I have skim milk powder, a third of a cup of sugar, 1.5 teaspoons salt, 1 teaspoon vanilla, 2 eggs, 1/3 cup oil, 4 1/4 to 5 cups of unbleached all-purpose flour and oil. Mix together yeast, warm water, and a pinch of sugar.
Large mixing bowl,
1/2 cup of warm water,
1/2 cup, 1/2 cup,
5 teaspoons of dry yeast. Here's our yeast. This yeast smells. 5. And a pinch of sugar. Pinch of sugar. Oh, that smells bad. That's 5 teaspoons of dry yeast. Oops. And a braid. Allow to stand for a couple of minutes to allow the yeast to swell or dissolve. It's swelling. Look. Swelling. Stir in remaining sugar, milk, vanilla, eggs, oil. Okay, we need 1/3 cup of sugar. 1/3 cup, 1/3 cup, 1/3 cup. In it goes. Add 1 cup warm milk.
I don't really know what how to do this.
Well,
I mean, let's do it.
The ingredients in beaver tails, they don't smell good. We need 1 teaspoon vanilla. Oh, that smells good. Oh, that's more like it. These are the things I like the smell of.
Yummy, yummy.
I don't think a little extra will hurt. 2 eggs. Oh, I feel like I'm speed baking. 2. Oil. 1/3 cup of oil.
Corn oil.
I think that's a good choice. Looks healthy to me. There it is. In it goes. 1.5 teaspoons of salt.
Smells good.
Oh my gosh. And most of the flour to make the dough soft. So we're gonna go 4 1/4 cups of flour. Oh. Tap, tap, tap. Tap, tap, tap. After this is all mixed in, knead with a K, the dough, by hand or with a dough hook. I don't have a clue what a dough hook is. We are going to do it with our hands. Add in the rest of the flour as you knead it.
As you knead it.
Knead it. Knead it until you get elastic dough. Now that's curious to me. All that flour is gonna eventually make its way into your dough. So you wanna be careful and kind of keep track of how much flour you use. This dough is very, very sticky. Sticky.
Yeah.
Now to knead the dough, you fold and go. Fold and flatten for 5 to 8 minutes. You can go do what you need to do. This seems way more advanced than the last one. I actually feel like I'm, you know, creating something honorable. But give it a massage and squish it. And, so, good thing I'm doing this exercise. I'd be curious to know what a dough hook is. My heart rate is up. This feels quite nice. I think I'm at cardio level. I wonder if Wendell Clark saw my gingerbread video. You know, that'd be awesome. Now, does this look elasticy to you? I'm making beaver tails. It's like a stress ball. You just squeeze when you're angry. I didn't realize I was so angry. I'm making When you're done beating it, place it in a greased bowl. And you place the bowl in a plastic bag and seal. Grease it. It's going in the greased thing, a plastic bag. Yep, I guess the dough rises now. Let it sit for 30 or 40 minutes. I'm kind of excited to see what's in there. Okay, wow, that was like an extreme close-up of my head. It has been 40 minutes, more than 40 minutes. I got caught up playing Scrabble online. We need to gently deflate the dough. I don't really know what that means. Ooh, it filled up. I think perhaps it means to poke it. I hear air, watch. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing. It's pretty puffy. The size of that handprint. It's a good thing I'm a volleyball player. I'm just gonna do a quick Google on how to deflate dough. Apparently, punch it. I don't know that punching into a glass bowl is the best idea. I have a feeling I'm gonna need this. It's the baseball bat roller. Pinch off a golf ball. It's about the size of a golf ball, right? Roll into an oval. Golf balls are that size. Now that's a sport I am really, really bad at. Heat about 4 inches of oil in a fryer. A wok works best, but you can use a Dutch oven. Or whatever you use for frying. Dutch oven. I'm so immature. I'm gonna use this because I just think that this is a really good sealant. Maybe I should look up how to extinguish an oil fire. How to put out an oil fire in the kitchen. Extremely flammable. It's not 4 inches. Call 911, but there's a lot in there. Cover it with a pan or a lid. My lid is ready to go. We're gonna let that heat up. We're gonna go back and make the rest of our little beaver tail, guys. That one has broccoli in it. Stretch the ovals into a tall shape like a beaver tail. This is a lot. I would have enough beaver tails to feed the Canadian junior team to make them feel better. Not that they have anything to feel bad about. Bronze is great. I mean, third in the world. Although I did have Boney M in my head for the next few days after that. Oh, those Russians. Turn them once to fry until the undersides are deep brown. Lift the tails out with tongs. Drain them on paper towels. Stretch out the ovals to make a tail. Stretching it. Wow, really stretch this out. They're like this big, maybe. I think I'm gonna bring beaver tails to the neighbors. It's kind of puffing up. You're actually making it brown. Oh yeah, baby. Really, really brown. Fill a large bowl with a few cups of white sugar, toss the tails in the sugar, shake off the excess, and ta-da! Gonna get a bowl like that. Ta-da! Cinnamon. Ta-da! And lots of sugar. Oh, may as well dump it all in there. All your cinnamon and your sugar is in there. Look at those puppies. That's how they're supposed to look, is like this one right there. Definitely a Canadian treat. Good to eat it in the winter. When you're, you know, trying to insulate. Very, very crisp looking. Throw it in here. I just made a beaver tail. I'm so excited. That is a beaver tail. My lid for fire prevention. Yes. Thanks for hanging out. Maybe I need to lay off the coffee. Someone proposed to me just now. Because they knew I was making beaver tails.